Come on, man. Real MC right there.
Facts.
Real MC, Tracy G. This man has been a mainstay on our show. Not just the show. You know, I remember when I first started doing radio, we used to play artists that we wanted to help set the tone of what people can expect. Those artists being of a certain yoke, you know, how they presented their music, their authenticity, their innovation, their drive, you know, their purpose. This particular artist that we have up here today has been coming up to the show for a couple of years, but most importantly, what I love about him is the conversations that we would have beyond the show. And it's always special when you make a connection with a person who becomes beyond the artist.
Yeah.
You know, what he shares about his beliefs. This man has been in the front lines fighting for justice, you know, using his platform to speak about disparities and injustice, using his platforms to talk about the unfairness that we see in today's society, but also being someone who's a great entertainer. He's a great thinker. You know, one of the things I love most is his relationship with his mom that he even shared with us publicly. I've seen this man on many platforms speaking on behalf of hip hop and just being very real about it. Very practical about it, who he is as an artist and who he is as a person. But when he went into business with his mother, I said, yo, this guy is different. He's making his mother money with his brand mom's whiskey. I wish all kids would do that with their parents.
Let's go.
When Gwen Kiyomi.
Yeah, I'm talking to my own if she's paying attention right now. But he's here today to talk about his new album. It's been out, but I've been up on it for a minute. I love the musical composition on it, and I love the messaging in it. And so I want to welcome him back, citizens, to pick up the album now while we are here. While we're here, the one and only Marlon Craft.
Great to be back, man.
Marlon Craft.
Happy to see the hair still long, too.
Thank you. Yeah. I was even trying to get a little cut before I came up here, but I've just been.
Long hair don't care.
Long hair do not care.
Does hair give you a different response depending on the length of your hair when you're in the public circles?
Yeah, for sure. People just like the long hair better.
Really?
Yeah. Like, it's just been a cool thing. And it's been cool. Like, when I was young, I was a hooper.
Okay.
So I never wanted to have long hair because it got in the way. Like, you know what I mean? I always had, like, and I was trying to figure it out because I was like a city kid, and like, so I was like getting shape ups and shit back in like high school, but it didn't really work because I had the white boy hair. It was like, you know, so now I feel like we've arrived in a good place, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, we're here now.
White boy hair.
You know what, Marlon, speaking of being here now, like as Sway mentioned, like, we remember you. We remember when you first came out, you was first coming out, you came up here. Is this game and hip-hop and success and all, is it what you imagined? Because I remember wanting to be an artist and making it. And I had these ideas of what I thought it would be, from practicing my autograph, all the stuff. And then I got in it. I was like, okay, this ain't the video. This ain't the, you know. How has it, because seeing you now, like, how has it been for you, if you don't mind kind of sharing that?
I think it's just been, I always knew it was going to be a lot of work, but it's been way more work than I even anticipated. And
right.
Like the length, because just once I started getting into the inner workings of it, making decisions about how I wanted to do it and sort of taking this longer independent, grind road that I've taken, and how, just seeing like what a marathon it really is. That's kind of been the surprise. And then, like, you know, just everyone has kind of, it's become kind of trite to say, but you just meet certain people that maybe you looked up to, or you get in certain rooms, and it's just like, man, these people in here don't even know themselves in these rooms. I thought they were like really ill, and that's why I love coming here, because like, just is a rare, it's a rarity. This was one of my like first real kind of like music industry moments being here with y'all, and I was blessed that it was filled with actual authentic people that care about the culture.
Thank you. Is that what Nursing the Blind is about a bit?
Yeah, Nursing the Blind, yeah, it's kind of just about just the impending doom of the world. Like, it's a dark ass album.
I feel like that's when reality really settles into Heather's point. You know, we all kind of have an idea of what the industry is going to be, and there's like such a focus on the glitz and the glam, et cetera, et cetera. But one of the first lines that stands out to me in that opening track is when you say, celebrity is a distraction.
Yeah, what's a celebrity really but a distraction?
Yeah,
it's like you start to get up here and then you realize, like, oh, even the people that you like are just regular. They're just regular
people
human beings.
People are people.
People are people. And so then you start, it's not all negative. Like, it's giving me more empathy. Like, now whenever people are, like, shitting on somebody publicly or whatever, I'm like, you don't know what they're going through. Mm-hmm. Like, you don't know how difficult their day-to-day is, the decisions they have to make. It's not to excuse a lot of the fuckery that we see at the top of shit, but
right.
You know what I mean? It's like, you just don't know. Like, it's very different. And I'm not even that famous like that. So, but, like, I know that people have misconstrued images of what my day-to-day is like. Mm-hmm. So if that's like that for me, then imagine what it's like for some of these people that are way more in the public eye than me. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, for sure.
Marlon Craft, you could go back to that. I feel like it was 2015 maybe when you came up here. 16,
yeah, maybe 16.
Wow.
16.
Yeah. The last time?
17.
The first time.
Oh, the first time. Okay.
The first time. So if you compare, like, even listening to your music from back then to listening to now and the experiences you had. What's that for, Ty? You about to serve us cake?
celebration, bitches.
Marlon bought whiskey and cake.
No, did you bring cake?
Oh, that's right, Ty.
Oh, look at Ty.
I'll let it be known, this is not a shameless plug. I just brought this as a gift.
Yeah.
But Sway, as the big homie, you know, entrepreneur that he is, you know, is like, man, you need to put that on the fucking table.
And you bought for everybody.
Yeah, his mom's
whiskey. I did.
Yeah, I can't wait to drink it. I just love your conversation listening to this album. And I'm glad you said it was a dark album, because I was listening to the album again. I went back to listen again. Let me refresh myself. And I was on the phone with a friend of mine who's a music lover. And whenever I got new music, you know, I'll send it to her and get her feedback. And she said, before I listen, what do you think? I said, the musical composition I really enjoy, because it's like, to me, a hodgepodge of emotions that are taking place that is cohesive in a way that only he can make it. Mm-hmm. Right, it's very distinguished to who you are, but sonically, there's a lot of what I call, and I don't know what the technical term is, just kind of like downtones to it.
Yeah,
right. And I react to downtones. My body chemically, when I hear certain octaves, you know, it does something to me.
Yeah.
And no matter what song, there's always that moment where shit, he's staying consistent with the downtone. And in one of the songs, what is it? Cool Gray 11s. I don't know.
Cool Gray 11s. Yeah.
Okay, what is that?
Like the sneakers.
Oh, sneakers.
Okay, I was like, what
11s.
Okay, I was like, is he doing these titles, man? Whatever. Okay, Cool Gray 11s. You talk about when you write. Now you say you write better in bed at 4 a.m. That's a line you say.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's why when I heard that line, that's why it's probably always dark. But is that true?
Yeah, I mean, it just seems like something about those creative hours when nobody else is awake and you're just like confronted with yourself. And it just was dark, man. I mean, it's been feeling dark. I don't know about y'all. It's been like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what I feel like nursing the blind is, that thing. Like, I feel like a lot of artists are just this idea of nursing the blind. It's like, I'm not trying, my purpose in the game is not to like feed you shit to necessarily like blind you any more than everything else in media is already blinding you. Like, my agenda is to not like make you feel shitty, but just to like bring that realness and say like, oh, there's someone out there that's seeing the things I'm seeing, but kind of making it sound a little bit beautiful. Like, that's what great art does to me. It's like, even when it's dark, you know, and just keeping that little sprinkle of hope in there and just kind of calling it like I see it. And I felt like an imperative to make the album that way, because I was just like, this is how I feel. And it's like, this album like took a real toll on me, honestly, finishing it personally, because it was like so dark, and like getting into the weeds of it was just like, I just wanted it to be done. Like, you know, it wasn't the work. As an artist, there's certain stuff that you do that's like really fun. Mm-hmm. And then there's certain shit that you do that you just have to
do. You gotta get it done.
That makes sense with Hans Zimmer too. Just thinking about this Oscar award winning composer and the sounds, you know, going into like those down tones that you're talking about, Sway. And him being an inspiration in terms of the way that he soundtracks.
Yeah.
And it sounds like he's kind of guiding. But we do have like an up-tempo, some levity with Cocky Humble.
Cocky Humble.
I would say.
The oxymoronic title. Cocky Humble.
Another great title.
That's hip-hop, you know?
Yeah.
So being a kid that grew up in Hell's Kitchen, I have a strong connection with Hell's Kitchen. I went to high school there.
Oh, fine.
And so Hans, Park West.
Okay.
So, you know, that's right in the middle where, you know, running from chewing officers and jumping the fence and then spraying graffiti on the handball courts.
Yeah.
And so Hans Zimmer to me feels like a day going through Hell's Kitchen, like in my high school years. So what was the concept?
Yo, it's so funny that you say that. There's the line in the hook that's like, they try to rob me from my merm when I had North Face money. You remember dudes always used to wear the biggies, you know what I'm saying? And but it was like, everyone would always get robbed from these expensive coats, right? These Marmot jackets. I had a North Face. I purposely didn't get a biggie because I'm like, I don't need this smoke in my life. But I had a North Face that was like the same style. I like took the hood off and this happened to me a couple times, but outside Park West, I was walking home and like walking by Park West, and dudes tried to play like, "Yo, what's up with that merm, son? Like, what's good?" Da-da-da. And I just like kept it pushing and keep moving. But that's where that line in the song actually comes from. Is like winter days growing up in New York, like people just pressing you, like you're not even trying to like be involved in something to be pressed for. You getting pressed, like that cold feeling that just people of like my generation and later can relate to. So that's hilarious that you said Park West. That's fire.
Yeah, that's fire. Marlon Craft is here. We're talking about While We're Here, which is his new project. World Champ is getting a really great response. Why do you think that is?
You know, that song, when I made it, it was just like I sent it to a couple people that I like usually send stuff to, like family or people that are really close to me. And everyone just loved it, like off rip. And I think it's just because that song is just me. Like, I don't know how to explain it. It just sounds like me. Like, it's so me in a song. And the people that really know me, I think that's why they loved it so much and it resonated, because they're just like, this is just you. Like, this is how you talk. This is how you feel. This is the essence. It's interesting. It's in, like, 6/8 time signature. It's, like, a little different. So whether people realize that or not, I think that's appealing, that it's got a little bit of a different vibe. And there's people like, I think people like the way that I talk about my family.
Absolutely.
Like, you know, like, I try to do it honestly, you know, and I think everyone can relate to that, you know. So.
Absolutely. Yeah. I took some notes because there was one song I felt like your split personalities was showing.
It's called being an artist, duality.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, in this near, that's the song. I was like, yo, he just bugged out in the end. Like, who did you turn in? You transform. It was like Bill Bixby turning into the Hulk.
Yeah.
Yeah. What happened in that moment of transformation of that song?
I made that in 2020 over Zoom.
Wow.
With Arbus, who's in Sweden, and my man X-Man, who's in LA. And I made several of these songs over Zoom, actually, still. Some of the songs are like, a lot of them, the foundation for the album was in 2020, like during still like real peak COVID shit. And that shit just felt like how it felt. Like, it just felt like, yo, we're here, bro. Like, I don't know if people, that song's kind of like the eerie thesis of like the centerpiece of the album. It was just like, and I was experimenting with doing these different voices and stuff, because, you know, I kind of got like a low voice, and like sometimes like I was like, I need to express this, like this kind of different type of voice inside me that is just screaming and it's just trying to figure it out. And then got into that bag, and yeah, people have been receiving that really well, the voice thing. So I got a lot, like, just, I've been learning more with my instrument, you know, like how to work it more, you know. So
I like that. Marlon Craft is here.
Marlon, I'm going back again just in terms of artistry. We were obviously just talking to CJ Wallace before you came in, and Sway and I, all of us really just talking about what it felt like being artists ourselves when his album came out, when that Ready to Die dropped, and how if you were even in the game, that album just made you take your notebook and just say, fuck it, I gotta start all over. This dude just crushed it. How do you take in other artists' music? Like Kendrick just dropped. Do you ever feel like, damn, like, what lane was he in? I wish I could talk to him. Why didn't I get a call? Just like some of those things. I mean, that's what I used to think. I'm not saying everybody does, but for me, just being fully transparent.
Yeah.
Do you have those thoughts as well sometimes?
I wish I was in a circle to like get a call about something like that. Like, that's an aspiration, you know. Like,
for
Kendrick,
sure,
Kendrick's my biggest inspiration, like bar none, easily.
Absolutely.
Like, I've always said that. Like, he's one of the greatest artists, I think, to ever live. I think we actually don't appreciate it as much because we live in the same time as him.
Mm-hmm.
Not to sound all hyperbolic and shit, but
no,
it's like,
I get it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, sometimes we can't accept. It's like, you living with somebody, you know, so I'm, you know, so I was just grateful like everybody else to get a new Kendrick album. But there was part of me that was like, yo, you gonna wait 5 years and then drop your shit 5 days before my shit?
Yeah. like, bro, I thought we was
right.
Cool in my head.
Like, imagine,
bro,
how Jack Harlow felt.
I mean, I know he don't know who probably who I am or whatever.
You'd be
like,
surprised.
I was gonna say, but
actually Tay Beast did Something's Wrong in Heaven, who produced for Kendrick for years, and TD and all those guys. But yeah, I was just grateful to get the album. and I couldn't push it back because I got like tour coming up and everything like that. But I think it works because it works perfectly because Kendrick's album such an incredible and important like piece of art.
Yeah.
But I was saying like, yo, by 5 days, like you always ready for that next album where you want to take a break when you're listening to something over and over again. The Kendrick album, incredible. But I was ready for a break after my first listen through, like, because like, I teared up listening to that album. Like, it was really heavy. So I was like, this is perfect. I think they work in tandem, and I don't think it's like, you know, a bother. But yeah, that should be stressful sometimes when you see it. You're just like, damn.
Marlon Craft, I say you in it. You, this album is out at the perfect time.
Yeah, you
out at the perfect time, man. So listen, speaking of time, two things has to happen. Heather B got to go to her next show,
Word.
Urban View, but she looking like, is he going to spit bars?
Because I'm a fan.
There it is. Now she's hanging out. So I want to. Yeah. This is a real MC. I ain't even got to ask him if he got something ready. Look at him. That's what the water was about.
You see, you saw that? You saw that?
Right on pause.
You heard that snigger? Yeah. Yep.
Now, this is JC Jace on the ones and twos. DMC champion.
Ooh.
I say champion. BLS, Hot 97. He's been around the world. In fact, Biggie, before Mr. C, once pointed him out as requesting that he be his DJ, according to JC Jace.
Ooh.
Today, he's your DJ.
Pleasure.
We don't know what he gonna throw on.
Hey,
ooh.
DJ Premier,
JC Jace.
Shout out Premier. All right, we ready?
Yes.
Yeah. A lot of cats in Huey shirts, but that Uncle Ruckus started in the city, but they forgot you, Tony Douglas. Drop gems, I never tuck it. Compose a quartet on the strings of the puppets.
Let's go.
How I work this hard without rushing. Bitch, I want it. If you did, you'd have done it. My hair look luscious. My soul on crutches. I goes on, fuck it. Score more with less touches. Anyone who tried to write me off, God already did. Dude scared of they reflection, what the problem is. I tried to sell you, tried to tell you. So don't act like I did it when the client tell you. Y'all still doing puck-ups to billionaires. Don't critique a fighting soldier while you sitting there. Yeah, I sling hope and distribute care. There's expensive and then there's rare. Yeah. Pure motive with a hint of fuck you. Could've chose to be real, but you didn't want to. Do it all myself, rarely brag on it. Cause they should know it's stamped if the name Craft on it. Hope my future bright cause my past haunted. But got on the right track and did laps on it. They treat songs like those mid-20s baldies. They just always throw some cap on it. They ain't ready for the truth. Me, I'm heady in the booth. Deadly is some proof that I'm forced to see. Got me sweaty in the loof. Never slept as good as they do on me. So I can't relate to why they won't accept me in the group.
Woo.
Shit, I'm good though. You can keep your cool table. I'm good, yo. I don't need the free meal. I cook, bro. Shit, you must have had me mistook. Hold on, see, I made a living off shedding this pain in my room. Off combating everything about me they would assume. Off making opposite what they told me they would consume. I've been patient, now I'm making a move. Cause I could drop a classic, they would just snooze. So I'ma drop a classic, make it a few. Just to show them that shit that they couldn't do. They front for you, but I see how mad it's making them. Ooh, ooh. I'm from Hell's Kitchen. Make my luck fuck well. Wishing we all got bars, my bells different. Mind, they don't own their business though. I supposed to lose, might be the first to win MVP and most improved. They do the most, I just got the most to do. So don't call me this year, man. Look, I'm in my bag from the moment I'm awake. The secret ain't complicated, it's just not being fake. Some of these guys cool, they just not being great. I'm trying not to judge them, but that's just not me of late. I'm barely inspired to write these shits no more. I got little to prove, my shot dribbling moves. I hop skipping some moons from knocking the cocoon. Y'all got me and confused, the world about to see the wings. But I've been on them Hall of Fame and I don't need the rings. I played the game my way and didn't cheat a thing. Shit, I used to crave the respect and cred till I realized it's all for self-gain and respect is dead. A lone warrior like when Draymond's out and it's on Stephen's head. That's a lot to carry, shit. So you better keep your dribble, keep it civil. Cause these snakes slithering and I don't speak in riddles. See me and they know me now, I don't need credentials. From how I make a living, speaking wisdom. Leave the crib with headphones in my aura like I just need essentials. You can catch a chancla to the face still if it be an issue though. Shit, that's what I call a mistletoe. You feel me? Cause like a shoe, it's like flying through the air. I say a lot of shit that's risk to know. The burden of the truth weighs heavy, I get resentful bro. Rap game, Jeff Van Gundy. Disgusted by the league I love. In rare form, cause I confronted all the me's I was and told them it was time to grow into the me I love. I've been in rooms you wanna be in, they don't love themselves there. A smogger posturing in front of me just covers the air. It's palpable, you can feel all of the gluttonous despair of dudes who thought they knew what they want but was underprepared. Cats call it like they see it but ain't seeing it at all. So what they say the truth really just be the fog. Gotta crawl before you walk. Who's really beyond the cross? Why they can't run away from the silliness of it all? So getting real tired of telling you who I'm better than. It's kind of a depressing spin, but if they need a lesson, then I'm not hard to find. On my time, got less to spend, so I might not respond if it ain't worth my attention. Then this peace of mind shit is something I would recommend. I'd rather learn from every loss than regret some wins. The truth is, we ain't too different, I'm just less pretend. So if y'all ready to grow shit, then let's begin. Yeah. Not to be working for me, while cats still looking around for a person to be. Personally, worth can't be purchased to me. It's gonna take me about as long as a surgeon's degree to personally see the riches they assume is my intentions. I invested in myself and it was worth it to me. They made you think working for you was working for free, but I'm really past issuing these urgent decrees. You don't got that fight in you, you can't learn it from me. Shit. I'm Bruce Lee with a kick drum. Who he is an insum. Choose me, the regret come. I've been proving them wrong since I ain't have income. Yeah, the Mike Conley of rap. Even if they don't get the facts, no, I'm gonna get my max. If they tackling the issues, then I'm Warren Sapp. Stop selling me you care, it's a boring act. Yeah. Commodification nation. You not an artist if money's your only way to greatness. Living in a land where we turn justice to a product and friendship to a business deal, we must get something out of. Back when dudes rock Nautica with patent leather Pradas, I was trying to find an image of myself that I was proud of. And now that mirror don't lie, and neither do I. Took me a couple decades to see through my own eyes. The living embodiment of if you know, you know. I just show you the light, and if you grow, you grow. Cats gonna do they dirt, and you gonna reap the seeds you sow. You talk the path, holla at me when you bleed it though. Everybody trying to win with the same playbook, but you the only one who really know how your strengths look. Yeah, they gave you a bag, but look what they took. You know there ain't no such thing as halfway crooks. Yeah.
Marley Crap,
I had to put my sunnies on.
Oh, the sunnies is on.
I ain't brought the sunnies out in 2022. The room is illuminated right now. Wow. And it's shining a light on you.
Wow, Marlon. That was so good.
I appreciate you guys.
Talk your shit.
All right.
We got any tour dates? Like,
the tour is coming. Thank you. Yes, we're doing the tour. We starting with a little Midwest, Northeast tour. In June, so a couple 3 weeks, we go in like Chicago, Columbus, Cleveland, Toronto, D.C., New York, and Boston, and then I'm going to Europe for the first time in September.
Incredible.
We're doing a bunch of dates. Thank you. And then we're going West Coast is going to be in November. We're working on those dates now.
Okay.
MarlonCraft.com. Get your tickets, man. Come through. I'm ready to see people again, see human beings, and feel it.
I want to be there in New York.
Yeah, definitely. I got y'all
absolutely.
For sure.
Absolutely. Yeah, Marlon, sure. Thanks for coming through.
Thank you, man.
You're awesome, man. Congratulations.
Yes. Oh, thank you so
absolutely,
much.
Absolutely, man. Marlon Craft, make sure y'all pick up the album while we're here.